students. I am Marianne E. Almudiente, your grade 8 science teacher. We are now on the first week of the fourth quarter, and we will be discussing digestive system.
Our most essential learning competency is to explain ingestion, absorption, assimilation, and excretion. For today's objectives, at the end of the lesson, you will be able to identify the parts of the digestive system and its functions, describe the processes involved in digestion, and promote healthful practices and proper nutrition to attain the digestive wellness. So what is digestive system? It is a system that prepares food for use by all your body cells. It produces various chemicals to break down the food, filters out harmful substances, and gets rid out of solid waste. There are two types of digestive system: the complete digestive system and incomplete digestive system. Complete digestive system has two openings wherein there is ingestion and excretion. Incomplete digestive system has only one opening to the digestive tract. These are the organisms that has complete digestive system. Number one is the shark, salamander, lizard, pigeon, and the cow. And the example of the incomplete digestive system is the hydra. So what is digestion? It is the process by which food is broken down into smaller, usable molecules and chemical compounds. There are two types of digestion: the mechanical digestion, which changes the physical form of food, and the chemical digestion, which changes the chemical composition of food with the aid of the digestive enzymes. So what is digestive enzymes? These are the special proteins that help break up large molecules of food into very tiny molecules that can be absorbed and used by the cells in the form of nutrition. Digestive tract. It is a long muscular tube with many sections and different areas. It includes the mouth, where the food enters, and the beginning of digestive process. Saliva. It moistens food and contains the enzyme ptyalin. So what is ptyalin? It is a salivary amylase which begins the digestion of starch by breaking it into smaller polysaccharides. Salivary glands. It is a gland that produces and secretes saliva into the oral cavity. It has three parts: the parotid, which beneath the cheeks, submandibular, which below the jaw bones, and the sublingual, which below the tongue. Pharynx. It is the area at the back of the throat that connects the nose and mouth to the digestive and respiratory tracts. Epiglottis. It is a small flap of tissue in which food and air are directed to the proper passage. It closes the trachea during swallowing. Cardiac sphincter. It is a ring-like valve at the junction of the esophagus and the stomach. It relaxes to allow the passage of the food. The function of the stomach is to churn and grind food. It is a muscular sac that is shaped like a letter J and has an inner folds called rugae. Rugae, it increases the surface area of the stomach. The stomach has gastric juices which contain hydrochloric acid and enzymes. So what is hydrochloric acid? It helps break down food and kill bacteria that might come along with the food. Another uses of stomach is the pepsin, which breaks down proteins. Mucus. It lubricates food so that it can travel through the digestive tract more easily. It coats the stomach wall protecting the muscle tissue from being broken down by other digestive fluids. The chyme is a thick liquid made up of partially digested proteins, starches and acids, and undigested sugars and fats. With the help of pyloric sphincter, the small amount of chyme will pass into the small intestine. There are three parts of small intestine. The duodenum, which is the upper part of the small intestine. It is 10 inches long, connected to the stomach. It is an area where digestive juices from the pancreas and the liver combine with the chyme coming from the stomach. Followed by the jejunum, and third is the ileum, where food are further broken down. Large intestine, or what we call the colon, it is 5 feet long, has a large diameter and shorter than small intestine. It absorbs water and the water-soluble vitamins from the mineral remaining in the digestive tract. It also stores undigested food. Next, the food will become feces. It is a solid waste matter that remains from undigested material. The feces will stay in the rectum before it is excreted. It is the final and expanded portion of the large intestine. Next part is the anus. It is a ring-shaped structure serve as the opening of the rectum. It is the opening through which solid waste passes from the body. The other parts of the digestive system is the accessory parts or the digestive glands. It produces or store enzymes and chemicals that help break down food. These are the liver, gallbladder, and the pancreas. The liver is the largest gland in the body. It stores certain vitamins and sugar in the form of glycogen. It produces bile. So the bile is not an enzyme. It is a watery greenish substance that acts as an emulsifier, which dissolves the fat into the watery contents of the intestine. Next is the gallbladder. It is a small sac-like organ connected to the liver. These are the digestive enzymes that helps break down the food. Number one is the carbohydrates, which helps break the carbohydrates. It includes the thiamine or the salivary amylase, lactase, and the maltase. Proteases, it helps break down the proteins. It includes the pepsin and the bromelain. And the lipases, which helps break the fats. It includes the gastric lipase and the pancreatic lipase. The first step to obtain nutrients is ingestion. It is a process where food is taken in through the mouth. In here, the breaking down of food into smaller pieces takes place in the process called digestion. Mechanical break starts with the mastication or chewing in the mouth. Teeth crush and grind large food particles, while saliva initiates the chemical breakdown of food and enable its movement downwards. The digested food or the bolus moves from the mouth down the alimentary canal, passing through the pharynx, esophagus, stomach, and small intestines. In the small intestine, the process of absorption takes place where digested food is taken into the bloodstream through the villi. It will be absorbed by each cell of the body in the form of energy in the process called assimilation. Meanwhile, the undigested food is pushed into the large intestine where water is reabsorbed. Feces will be stored in the rectum to be expelled through the anus via defecation. Here is the diagram of the process of digestion. So we are done with the discussion of digestive system. Now let us have an activity called Fact or Bluff. Number 1. Stress and spicy food cause stomach ulcers. Is it a fact or a bluff? For those who answered bluff, you get a point. Stress and spicy food has nothing to do with the stomach ulcers. It is because of the bacteria called Helicobacter. Number 2. You can swallow food when you are upside down. For those who answered bluff, you are correct. Regardless of the posture, the food will travel down due to the peristalsis or the muscle contractions. Number 3. If your stomach gurgles, it always means you are hungry. For those who answered bluff, you are correct. The stomach gurgling that you hear is usually stomach muscles and the movement of your last remnants of your last food. Number 4. Raw carrots are more nutritious than cooked. For those who answered bluff, you are correct. Cooking and processing help the release of carotenoid present in the carrots. Number 5. Eating food with plenty of seeds will cause appendicitis. For those who answered bluff, you got it right. The appendix gets infected. It is because fecal matter hardened in the opening of the appendix.
So that's all for today. I hope you have learned and enjoyed our activities and lesson for today. Again, I am Marianne E. Almogente, your grade 8 science teacher. Bye!